In addition to global public health crisis, CAPS is creating havoc with the trade and travel industries. The frightening public health toll of CAPS continues to mount. Patients are overwhelming healthcare facilities around the world, including many of the makeshift triage and temporary care facilities. People are avoiding public spaces out of fear of infection and in compliance with public health recommendations. This has had a dramatic effect on the retail and service sectors. Businesses of all kinds are struggling to operate, let alone provide basic services as their workers have fallen sick or refused to come to work. Some companies have allowed telecommuting, but for most businesses and employees, this is not an option. Public health agencies have issued travel advisories, while some countries have banned travel from the worst affected areas. As a result, the travel sector is taking a huge hit. Travel bookings are down 45% and many flights have been canceled. A ripple effect is racing through the service sector. Governments that rely on travel and tourism as a large part of their economies are being hit particularly hard. Consumer confidence has fallen dramatically and people are delaying or canceling discretionary purchases. As a result, manufacturers are scaling back production on many goods. On the other hand, staples like food and medicine are being hoarded. Mandated border closures and trade restrictions are creating severe localized shortages. The Purchasing Managers Index suffered its sharpest decline in 50 years, a leading indicator that markets are preparing for a prolonged period of economic disruption. In some regions, politicians are adding to the noise and confusion through social media. Ban all goods and travel from infected countries, and boycott companies that spread disease are common Twitter refrains often led by public figures. It's safe to say we face a tough dilemma. The movement of people may facilitate the spread of CAPS, but interruptions to travel and trade may have economic consequences that are just as bad.
And to give us more detail on these issues before our discussion, Lucia Mullen.
CAPS is spreading, and it's largely due to the movement of people. Individuals from affected regions traveling to unaffected areas, and susceptible people traveling to affected areas and getting sick. Travel poses real health risks, both of spreading the disease and of travelers getting sick. In fact, many travelers to affected regions have gotten sick and some have died. Many countries have issued travel advisories for affected parts of South America. Additionally, politicians in a number of countries have called for bans on all travel and imports from affected countries. A few countries have actually banned all inbound travel and some trade from those countries. The total number of reported cases is currently about 30 times the total we saw with SARS and 100 times the number of MERS cases so far. And disruptions to both local and global travel and trade are commensurately greater. On the other hand, public health experts inform us that travel and trade bans and fever screens are not effective at preventing importation of a highly contagious respiratory illness. Studies suggest that at best, they can importation by a few weeks. Some countries have advised against travel to countries in South America. Others are advising against traveling to any country with cases. A few countries have even put bans in place for persons or goods coming from countries with cases. These disruptions are beginning to have major economic consequences for the South American region and will soon have cascading effects globally. We are anticipating far greater disruptions to trade and travel may be on the horizon. One prominent economist estimates that global GDP could fall an additional 4% as a result of travel and trade restrictions. This would cause a severe global recession. Such a severe recession has the potential to result in both high unemployment and runaway inflation, creating the groundwork for national instability and change in the global political landscape.